Hi, this is Tracy. It must be Sunday. It's my day on the At Late But Great channel. Today we are telling humorous stories in the coming out world. The question was posed by Mick, and I'll read it in its entirety. Time to lighten up and reflect on the humorous side of life. Since coming out can sometimes put us in awkward situations, tell a story or two about something funny that has happened to you that wouldn't have happened if you did not identify as LGBTQ. Well, I haven't been out all that long, maybe 2 years. I really haven't compiled a lot of stories, but I'm going to attempt to tell four. I'm involved in three of them. And we'll get started here in a second, but I want you to meet somebody first. Come here, girl. Come on, Molly. Come here. This is my new dog. We decided to name her Molly and not Scout. Long story. But there's my little sweetie. And there's my loy boy lying on the ground right there. So I've got two dogs, two cats, two kids. I think everything's about complete. On with the stories. Hi. Okay, I'm having a deck party tonight, and I'm out running errands, and you're coming along with me, so I can get this video done this weekend. It's going to be a very busy weekend. This story really doesn't have anything to do with a whole lot of humor. I found it funny, but, you know, I don't think it's ha-ha for everybody else. It just kind of shows, it showed me how people don't really understand the whole gay thing, and I was talking to one of my former college friends. I've known this woman for 30 years. She was with me the night before my daughter was born, and we went out for dinner and a whippy dip, and you know, so she's known me forever, and she's known my daughter since the day she was born. And when I came out to my group of college friends, one of my roommates sent a big mass email out stating, you know, kind of in a panic, what are we going to do when we go on couples trips? Who's Tracy's girlfriend going to hang out with? Is it going to be the men or with the women? And she was having a real hard time with that, and everybody kind of told her, don't put the cart before the horse. But anyway, one of my most liberal-minded friends called, and we were having a chat, and, you know, I'd only been out to her for about a month, and she was asking how I was doing. And so I started telling her about what I had done that weekend with my daughter. And I'm just going to say my daughter's Jane. So I said, you know, Jane and I did this and Jane and I did that. And she waited till I'd finished and she said, so is Jane your new girlfriend? And I just started cracking up and I'm like, you know, no, that's my daughter. You know her. And so she felt a little embarrassed and I just was kind of shaking my head thinking, wow, everybody's trying to be so PC or, you know, understanding of my life. And it turns out that it's really just people are don't know what to say, don't know what to do. So that was that introduction. Okay, my mom came to visit me one day. In I think it was February, and I'd been out to them for about, oh, probably 9 months, 10 months, something like that at that point. And I asked, you know, if they would come down and spend some time on a weekend. I hadn't really talked to them about my gayness much, and it was a really nice visit. My mom sat down and she wanted to ask me some questions just about my life and how I was doing. And one of those questions had to deal with if I was seeing anybody. Now, to preface the story, I had been in a marriage. So, you know, I was divorced after 22 years of marriage. And I told her I was seeing somebody, and I was very excited because this was a new relationship. And I told her, you know, the person I'm seeing is very nice, very sweet, athletic. We do a lot of things together. And I have a lot in common, and I said she's divorced. And that's when my mom said, are you sure she's gay? And I kind of paused and said, well, you know, I was thinking in my head, does she want details? And I said, well, what do you mean by that? And she said, well, She's divorced. And I, you know, the only thing I could do was look at her and go, hello, because I was divorced and I'm gay. So I think that story just kind of shows how people just really have no idea what goes on in our lives and how they work and what goes on in our inner selves. So that was my mom's story. She's okay with everything now, and I think she gets it. All right, next story. My girlfriend loves sushi, and she's a regular at a little sushi place locally. It's very small, just has the sushi crew and a hostess. One week she went in with a friend, a guy friend, and had dinner, who had been in town just for the week. The next week I went to dinner with her. So we walk in and we're seated, and they're basically booths in sort of a little pit, and you remove your shoes and sit down on these nice cushions, but you're kind of low to the ground. And it's a table, and we're sitting there and eating, and we're enjoying ourselves, having a good conversation, a few glasses of wine, and the conversation turned intense. And so I began to kind of rub her leg with my toe, because we had our shoes off, and thinking, you know, I'm being so covert here. The waitress came up and kind of had a shocked look on her face, and I just, you know, I didn't think anything about it, to be honest with you. When we got up to leave, I noticed, unlike regular tables at a restaurant, where a person is standing up kind of high and looking down, they can't see under the table. These tables being in the pit, you can see right to the legs. So I'm sure the little hostess saw me rubbing Karen's leg throughout the meal. Oh well. The next week, Karen went in with another friend of hers. And the hostess came up to her and looked at her and looked at her friend and looked at Karen again and said, "You with her now?" Karen just started laughing, because I think this hostess was sort of wondering what the heck's going on. First she's with a man, then she's with me and I'm rubbing her leg, and then she's there with another woman. So that's that story. Once again, people just don't understand. I think they assume things about being gay or gay behavior that really aren't true. Boy, I'm going to try to get all these finished while I'm running errands. Okay, this is the final story, and this does not involve me. I went out to dinner last year in the winter with a group of women, and two of the women in the group were a couple. One is a divorced woman with four children, and she has only been out maybe like 5 years, and she's coming from a marriage, very religious background, the marriage to a guy that works for CBN, the Christian Broadcasting Network, which is in Virginia Beach here, and worked for Pat Robertson almost directly. So very religious. She is now partnered with a woman who works for the Navy and as a contractor, and is a very big personality. And this woman also previously was partnered with one of Virginia's, our local area's well-known surgeons. So. You know, probably a big personality there too. So these two women, the one who's divorced with the four kids and the one who's a lifelong lesbian, are with us having dinner. And the divorced woman, I'm going to refer to them as divorced woman and the lifelong lesbian. The divorced woman begins to tell a story about the first time she met her partner, the lifelong lesbian's parents. They went to Miami to visit the mom and dad who lived in a retirement home down there. And as the lifelong lesbian described, they are a very liberal Jewish family from Long Island and very loud. So they go down there. This divorced woman had never met the family, and she's a little nervous about being there. The next day, the daughter, the lifelong lesbian, decides to go golfing or some outing with her dad and her brother. leaving the divorced woman. Now, these women are not partners yet. They just started dating. Leaving her to go shopping and lunch with the mom. So she said she goes downstairs and she waits for the mom to get the car and come around because they're living in sort of an apartment complex type thing, condo. And here, screaming around the corner, comes this big, like a Lincoln or something, and this little tiny woman sitting behind the wheel. And she's kind of looking up through the steering wheel to see. So the divorced woman gets in the car and they start driving off. And now they're in three, they're driving in six lanes. So there are three lanes going in one direction. And the divorced woman says, you know, that the mom is a pretty bad driver. She's in the far left lane, and she makes a right turn from there and just doesn't pay attention, and she felt like she was taking her life in her hands. Well, they take off and you know, they start to drive, and the mom looks over at the divorced woman and says, so what are your intentions with my daughter? So this woman's kind of taken off guard with the question, and she just said, oh, you know, I really like her. I think she's great. I think the mom had some suspicions because this woman was divorced and had four kids. And then, completely by surprise, the very next question was, so tell me, what do you both do? And the woman, you know, sitting in the car was like, you know, excuse me, what do you mean? And she said, you know, what do you girls do? Is there a lot of rubbing involved? And the woman sitting in the seat was just like shocked. She didn't even know what to say. And she just said, I don't understand. And the mom finally looked and said, you know, rubbing. And she had her hand above her crotch and was making this rubbing motion. Well, this woman was completely, just didn't know what to say. And she kind of, you know, blurted out, yes, there's some of that. And the mom kind of got quiet for a while and then said, I like rubbing. And she said, and the mom went on and said, I could have been a lesbian. I really like rubbing. And so the other woman just, you know, chalked it up as indoctrination into the family. You got to pay your dues. So that's that story, and I hope everyone has a wonderful week, and enjoy some rubbing. Bye.